Well, it's June 7th, and I would be remiss if I didn't do a mention of Prince, you know, Prince Rogers Nelson, a musician that passed last year, peace and blessing on his eternal soul. Speaking about, actually, it's appropriate because Purple, see, this is what I knew about Prince at the radio station. I used to be a music director at Wells. It's called Arts Director, which includes music director. And I introduced a lot of people to his music through that, through my dealings at WBAI Radio in New York. Anyway, just real quick, my boy, I guess it was Nelson. Nelson said, we have a small, very small group of Prince devotees. Nelson, it would be Jay Smooth, Lorianne, and Steve. That's my circle right there. It's a very small circle. It's the stuff. Anyway, the reason why I'm bringing Prince up is interesting because everybody thought it was very bad that Prince didn't have a will, you know, to do stuff. And of course, he didn't have any direct heirs in terms of children to pass his lineage, you know, his money onto, his wealth onto. But he was doing stuff. It's kind of interesting. And I would think about this since Nelson sent me this this article about how Prince took something like $250,000 and invested it in talked to Van Jones, you know, his boy, and invested in a solar startup situation in Oakland, California, which is where the Ella Baker, you know, center is, and where Van was instrumental in, he started that. Anyway, so at that, from that startup, that seed money, these tech companies, everything got together with some solar people, and anyway, they're doing renewable energy or solar stuff, I'll try to list the whole article someplace. I'll put the details for it. But what's interesting about that is that this startup, the situation is, I think they call it a lab or engine or whatever they call these fancy things, but it's fully of staff, at least 50% by women and so-called minorities. So that's a good thing. So what's more interesting, rather than wealth being passed on just to his immediate family, and you know what family does, it's always a nightmare, especially, you know, you're always disappointed in your children, they don't do it, whatever it is. But he's actually seeded institutions. So it's interesting, I think that, especially if you have a lot of money, it's more important to see institutions, so the institutional work goes on way beyond your family, whatever happened to your family, unless your family is going to do the institutional work. So even if you want to pass wealth on to your family, it's always important, especially in the black community, if you have a little bit of money, is to start some institution or support institutions that you agree with. And I think that cements your legacy. That's how legacy, that's how you remain in people's thoughts. So everybody else, sort of Prince music will, he's got enough music, will last forever. But I think the more important thing in the scheme of things, in the scheme of humanity, is not just the music, but also the institutions that you live to make the world a better place. So for that, again, I thank you that the great human being, the great human being that walked this earth for a while, for 57 years, we thank you so much, Prince Rogers Nelson. This is a shout out from me, T, from the Patterson's, taking the train to Tibet, letting you know what I only suspect.